Hey, my name is Miriam-Teak, and I've just won Best Actress in a Musical for my portrayal of Juliet in Anne Juliet.
It is sensational to have you here tonight. What does it mean for you and the rest of the team behind this beautiful production to be nominated and celebrated in so many categories by audiences tonight?
It's just been amazing. You know, it's so special because it's from the fans. And actually, when it went sort of live that you could start voting, we'd only been opened for sort of like a month really, or something like that. So it was a fresh show, it was a new show, and it's so amazing that people have resonated with it so early on and still continue to, and people go away feeling so inspired by this story. It's so special, and I'm so proud of every single category that we've been nominated for.
For people who haven't been lucky enough to experience the production for themselves, can you just give us the very briefest of synopsises of Anne Juliet and what it was as a storyteller that spoke to you about that narrative?
Yeah, so it's a reimagining of the famous Shakespeare play Romeo and Juliet, and it asks what would happen if Juliet decided she wasn't going to kill herself to go with Romeo, but she was going to live her life. What would that entail? And we sort of have it in the 21st century, and you have Shakespeare and Anne retelling this story together. And I loved the premise of this. I just thought it was absolutely brilliant. The fact that we're breathing this sort of autonomy into Juliet and making her like sit in the driving seat of her own life, I just loved everything about it. And the fact that it includes the songs by Max Martin, I was like, this is genius. This is just genius. And I couldn't wait to be a part of it.
I mean, why do you think, particularly in 2020, that message about women taking control of their own narrative rather than being subsumed within a more masculine narrative, why do you think that is seems so apropos?
Yeah, it's the perfect time. I mean, there's no time like the present. And, you know, when we sort of look back at what Romeo and Juliet was like, I believe that she's always been powerful and always had this innate strength, but she just wasn't able to present it and wasn't able to show this in that sort of society. But now, like, had she been around now, she would have been able to explore it. And we're so lucky in that in this day and age, women are able to be powerful and to speak their minds. And may that continue, long continue.
Just very quickly about the music, because obviously these are songs that are, again, iconic, but known and beloved. What's it like to get to perform them on stage?
It's incredible. I mean, these songs are already huge, huge songs, but the fact that Max Martin has trusted me to put my spin on these songs and make it so intrinsically but unapologetically me, and like add my own flair to it, and it's just been incredible. These songs are amazing, and he's an incredible writer, so honestly, anything he makes is going to be gold.
We're here tonight, obviously in the heart of the West End. What makes London specifically such a special theatre capital?
I just feel like the entire West End is one big family, literally. I just feel like, and there's so much energy and love and passion throughout all the shows, and I'm so proud to be a part of that.